Are you able to see that ray optics written on this whiteboard? Yes. Are you able to see this whiteboard? Yes. And this marker which I am having in my hand? Yeah. It is all because of a very important phenomenon of light called reflection of light. This is the phenomenon which helps us to see an object around us. So what is the reflection of light? When light falls on a surface, rigid surface, these rays of light reflects back in the same medium. These are the rays of light falling, and these rays of light are reflecting back, bouncing back. So the phenomenon of bouncing of light radiation back into the same medium from any surface is termed as reflection of light. Reflection of light is of two types. One is regular reflection and another is diffused reflection. How do you differentiate between regular and diffused reflection? As I told you, that light makes us able to see the object around us. There is an object called plane mirror where you can see a sharp image in the mirror. There is a newspaper which you read every day, but you are not able to see your sharp image in that. So a reflection in which sharp image of the object can be formed is termed as regular reflection. And the reflection in which image of an object is not seen, but object you can see, is termed as diffused reflection. There are certain laws which are obeyed by the light radiation. So, laws of reflection. Consider plane mirror. Draw a ray is incident on it. Draw an incident ray. At the point of incidence, drop a perpendicular geometrically. And then draw a reflected ray. So AB is reflected ray, OA is incident ray. This is normal. This angle is termed as angle of incidence. This is termed as angle of reflection. So the first law of reflection is angle I is equal to angle R. And the second law is incident ray, normal, and reflected ray all lie in the same plane. These laws of reflections are strictly obeyed whether your reflection is regular or diffused. It doesn't matter. In both the cases, the laws of reflections are obeyed. Now I will talk about spherical mirrors. How do we make a spherical mirror? Let's take a hollow sphere. And cut two parts of the hollow sphere. One I am cutting from this side, another from this. I can name these parts A, B and C, D. Moving these parts separately here. A, B is kept here. C, D is kept here. When I paint it from cavity side, this part A, B starts reflecting from bulging side. So this is a reflecting surface. reflection will take place from here. Such a mirror is termed as convex. When you paint it or silver polished on bulging side of the part, then cavity side starts reflecting. Reflection takes place from the cavity side. Such mirrors are termed as concave mirror. So, as far as definitions are concerned, it is easy to form a definition. What are spherical mirrors? A spherical mirror is a part of hollow sphere painted or silver polished on either side. What is convex mirror? It is a mirror which reflects light radiation from bulging part portion. What is concave mirror? It is a part of hollow sphere which reflects light radiation from cavity side. After knowing a spherical mirror, I would like to tell you here some important terms which are used in case of spherical mirrors. Some important terms. I am drawing a concave mirror. There are certain important terms. Listen me carefully. Midpoint or central point of mirror is termed as pole. With the help of this mirror, you can draw an imaginary sphere. And then locate the center of this sphere. This center of sphere is termed as center of curvature. An imaginary line passing through center of curvature and pole is termed as principal axis. Diameter of mirror is, that I mean to say AB, is termed as aperture of mirror. Distance between pole and center of curvature, this is termed as radius of curvature. So I repeat again, center of or midpoint of mirror is termed as pole, center of actual sphere of which mirror forms a part is termed as center of curvature. Imaginary line passing through center of curvature and pole of the mirror is termed as principal axis. Diameter of a mirror is termed as aperture. And the distance between center of curvature and pole is termed as radius of curvature. One more term which you are going to use very frequently. That is focus. What is focus? Before knowing about the focus, let me tell you first how to obtain image. In mirrors, you can easily obtain the position of mirror, a position of image formed in the mirror by following two rules out of any three rules. And what are these three rules? have a look separately. I am drawing diagram for you separately so that you can understand. This is concave mirror in all cases. Midpoint, principal axis, principal axis, principal axis, pole, pole, pole. Ray of light coming parallel to the principal axis passes through focus. Ray of light passing through focus becomes parallel to the principal axis. The ray of light passing through center of curvature reflects back. Out of these 3 points, any 2 points you can follow, right? And wherever the rays intersect, reflected rays actually intersect, or by extending these rays virtually wherever they extend, draw perpendicular on principal axis, you will get an image of virtual object. Now you can look at the importance of this term focus. Because everywhere and every time you have to draw a ray diagram in case of the mirror. And for obtaining ray diagram, you have to follow 2 rules out of these 3. So you must know what is focus. Yes. We have just seen that how to obtain image of an object. And in order to that, you know that we have told you 3 rules, and in each rule 2 points are very important and they are considered well. Point number 1 is focus is in every available in every present in every figure. Center of curvature is also playing very important role. So now another important term is focus. What is focus of the mirror? It is a point lying on a principal axis at which the rays of light coming parallel to the principal axis actually meet or appears to come from. I repeat, it is a point lying on a principal axis at which the rays of light coming parallel to the principal axis actually meet or appear to come from. Actually meet in case of the concave mirror and appears to come from in case of convex mirror. But we have to measure the distances also in order to calculate the size of an image, focal length, radius of curvature. So there is a proper sign convention. Sign convention. And I advise you to follow Cartesian coordinate sign convention. What is this? Every mirror has pole. Coincide origin of the Cartesian coordinate system with the pole. And then follow the Cartesian coordinate system. Sign convention. What is that? All distances measured this side are taken as positive. All distances measured towards negative x-axis are taken as negative. All distances measured along positive y-axis are positive. Measured along negative y-axis are negative. I think this is the easiest way to use sign convention. You have not to memorize it separately. We are already using maths. Now I will derive a relation between radius of curvature and focal length. Relation between radius of curvature and focal length. We derive this relation. Draw a diagram carefully. Mark center point as a pole. Draw a straight line passing through the pole. You can use a scale if you are not confident by freehand. Mark a force at certain distance. At the same distance from force, you mark center of curvature. This is incident parallel ray. It strikes to the mirror at point M, OM, and finally passes through the focus. Join C and M. Draw perpendicular, geometrical perpendicular line from M. This is MD. By definition, this is R. C and P, distance between C and P. Distance between focus and pole is focal length. I assume this angle of incidence is theta, so this is also theta. Then this is also theta, then this is 2 theta. How to work it out? Angle OMC is equal to angle MCF because of what? From laws of reflection. Angle OMC is equal to angle M, this would be MCMF, and this would be MCF. What is this? Alternate angles. Angle MFD is 2 theta because it is an exterior angle of triangle MFC. Now see, from right angle triangle MDC, tan theta is equal to MD over MD over MCD, and from right angle triangle MDF, tan 2 theta is equal to MD over FD. This you can give equation 2, this you can write as equation 1. For a small aperture of mirror, point D approaches to P. This implies CD is nearly equal to CP, and FD nearly equal to FP. Let us give it equation 3. For a small angle, theta tends to 0. Using trigonometrical identity, tan theta equals to theta, or tends to theta. This implies equation 1 becomes theta is equal to MD over CP, and from equation 2, theta is equal to MD over FP. Combining this equation as 4. Putting this value of theta here, so you will have 2 MD over CP is equal to MD over FP. MD, MD gets cancelled. What is left? 2 by CP is equal to 1 over FP. So CP is equal to 2FP. Canal place is equal to 2 fountain trap C. No, CP is R, joking. And this is F. So R is equal to 2F. This relation is true in case of mirrors.